Good morning again, everyone. Always great to see you and join together for this BCP service of praising God and coming a little closer to Him. So as we always do, let's start off just by stopping. Recognizing that God is present. Is that me or is that you? That's me, probably.
Might be me.
Oh, it might be you? Okay.
Oh.
Sorry. Let's just stop. Recognize that God is here. Do we have an opening hymn today?
We do.
Okay. So our opening hymn for today is 620. Would you please stand and sing with us as we sing, what is it?
How sweet the name of Jesus sounds.
How sweet the name of Jesus sounds.
So I suddenly realized I didn't have the earphones and whatever's on. So.
That's completely fine. 620, how sweet the name of Jesus. Service begins on page 67. Let us say together the collect. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it. Thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us, and we beseech thee. Lord, have mercy upon us. Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Grant, we beseech thee, merciful Lord, to thy faithful people pardon, peace, that they may be cleansed from all their sins and serve thee with a quiet mind, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated for the reading of God's word. Our first reading is found on page 252 in the Book of Common Prayer, if you'd like to follow along. First reading is taken from Paul's letter to the Ephesians, the 6th chapter, beginning at the 10th verse. My brothers and sisters, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not with flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the evil one. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints and for me, that utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in bonds, that therein I may speak boldly as I ought to speak. Here ends the first reading. For today's Psalms, we're going to be reading through Psalm 140 and Psalm 141. You find them on page 511. 511, Psalm 140 and 141. Normally I'd say we'll say odd and even, but you'll notice that it's only an even amount, so we'll just say them responsively. Actually, let's say them all together. That'll be easier. On page 511, Psalm 140. Deliver me, O Lord, from the evil man, and preserve me from the wicked man, who imagine mischief in their hearts and stir up strife every day. They have sharpened their tongues like a serpent. Adder's poison is under their lips. Keep me, O Lord, from the hands of the ungodly. Preserve me from the wicked men who are purposed to overthrow my doings. The proud have laid a snare for me and spread a net abroad with cords. Yea, and set traps in my way. I said unto the Lord, Thou art my God. Hear the voice of my prayers, O Lord. O Lord God, Thou strength of my health, Thou hast covered my head in the day of battle. Let not the ungodly have his desire, O Lord. Let not his mischievous imagination prosper. A slanderer shall not prosper upon the earth. Evil shall hunt the wicked person to overthrow him. Sure I am that the Lord will avenge the poor and maintain the cause of the helpless. The righteous also shall give thanks unto thy name, and the just shall continue in thy sight. Lord, I call upon thee. Hasten thee unto me, and consider my voice when I cry unto thee. Let my prayer be set forth in thy sight as the incense, and the lifting up of my hands as an evening sacrifice. Set a watch, O Lord, before my mouth, and keep the door of my lips. O let not my heart be inclined to any evil thing. Let me not be occupied in ungodly works with the men that work wickedness, neither let me eat of such things as please them. Let the righteous smite me in kindness, and let him reprove me. It shall be as oil for the head. Let not my head refuse it, but still my prayer shall be against their evil doings. But mine eyes look unto thee, O Lord God. In thee is my trust. O cast not out my soul. Keep me from the snare that they have laid for me, and from the traps of the evildoers. Let the ungodly fall into their own nets together, and let me ever escape them. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Please stand for the Gospel reading. Again, the Gospel is found on page 253. The Lord be with you. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John, the 4th chapter, beginning at the 46th verse. Glory be to thee, O Christ. There was a certain nobleman whose son was sick at Capernaum. When he heard that Jesus was come out of Judea into Galilee, he went unto him and besought him that he would come down and heal his son, for he was at the point of death. Then said Jesus unto him, Except ye see signs and wonders, ye will not believe. The nobleman said unto him, Sir, come down ere my child die. Jesus saith unto him, Go thy way. Thy son liveth. And the man believed the word that Jesus had spoken unto him, and he went his way. And as he was now going down, his servant met him and told him, saying, Thy son liveth. Then inquired he of them the hour when he began to amend. And they said unto him, Yesterday at the 7th hour, the fever left him. So the father knew that it was at the same hour in which Jesus saith unto him, Thy son liveth, and himself believed, and his whole house. This is again the second sign that Jesus did when he was come out of Judea in Galilee. The Gospel of Christ. Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. Where you are, would you bow your heads with me in prayer? Lord God, you know what we come against in this life. The struggles, the temptations, the desires. You know all those that stand in our way and stand in your way. And you know the way that our heart can stand in your way. And so, Lord, now we turn to you because you know the battle we face. You know the enemies. And so, Lord, we turn to you trusting in your strength, that you are the victor, that you are the one that might overthrow all evil. So, Lord, we ask for your protection, your guidance, your love, your forgiveness, your righteousness, your faith. May be planted in us so that we might be faithful through all the hard times. Amen. I think Paul's letter starts with something that we easily fall into, of seeing our struggles with the world as the main struggle. as the struggle that we need to overcome. You can even hear that in our psalm today, as the psalmist is praying against evil men. We so often go there first, right? Because we see it. We don't have to look far. You only have to turn on our television screen, walk down the street, go into the mall, whatever it may be, and we could see the evil all around us. But Paul in this moment is reminding us that there is a greater evil that we have to recognize. We have to acknowledge. But Paul doesn't go there first, and that's really important. Before he ever looks at evil, he looks at God first. And sometimes in our lives, we can get so wrapped up in the awfulness, in the evil that surrounds us, that we don't see God. That we actually don't put first things first. And so he starts with, find the strength of God. Know his might. Because then as we look at evil, then as we look at the strength and the hugeness of evil, then we might know how to overcome. Then we might know a greater strength than all of that. And that's really important. Because that's the only way we're going to overcome. We don't talk a lot about spiritual forces and spiritual evils, but I think we're less for it. Because the truth is that there is a lot of spiritual influences on our lives that are leading us in the wrong direction. And whether you believe in demons or not, the truth is that there is influences on us that are a lot bigger than the people or the society that we live in. Pointing us in other directions, trying to lay hold on our heart. So it's important to recognize these spiritual influences. And what Paul is trying to direct us to in this moment is that these are powerful influences. He calls them principalities, which means they literally have authority. He says them spiritual forces from high, not literally meaning that they're higher up literally than us, but means that they're more powerful, that they stand over us in a way. And we only need to look at our lives a few times to see that we have been overthrown, that we are easily overthrown, that we don't have the power on our own to overcome these forces. We again and again can be led astray. But after he first points to God's might, then he shows us who our true enemy is. Now he wants to show us is what are the very things of God that we can lay hold of that will help us through all of it. And these are actually immensely important. They might seem like just great words and that sort of thing, but he paints them in such a way that they should really help us. He starts with our girdle of truth, or our belt is more likely what we wear nowadays. That thing that holds us together. It holds us together in such a way, well, I think about nowadays, if I didn't wear a belt, my pants would fall and I'd trip. I literally wouldn't be able to move in the world, right? It would stop me, not mentioning the possible shame and all of that, the funniness of it all. But it helps me move in the world. And so living in truth helps us move, help us be held together. If you look at it another way, if we hold on to falsehood, if we hold on to something false about ourselves, false about the world, whatever it might be, and try to move in that, that will only be a great stumbling block. That will only be something that traps us and blinds us. Maybe not always, but at one point or another, it is going to get in the way. Next, he moves on to the breastplate of righteousness. So think about that. It's the breastplate. It's covering all of your organs except your mind, but we'll get to that. But it's covering all of that, but especially your heart. Now, the interesting thing is that our heart can prove false sometimes. I don't know about you, but ever so often I can be stricken with doubt. With doubt or unloving feelings, or doubt in myself or God. But if we allow righteousness to cover us, not necessarily always our own righteousness, because that doesn't always hold up, but God's righteousness, it will take that doubt. It will protect you from it. It will move you forward beyond it. It will show you how to use that anger, those hard feelings, how to move rightly with them. Then he talks about putting on the sandals, the shoes, shodding your feet with the gospel of peace. So think about it. Your feet are what make you move throughout the whole world, right? It is what leads you to meet someone, to act out in the world, to be present. So what God is saying in this moment is that you need to move with the gospel of peace. Not just an everyday peace, not just that peace that comes when things are going your way, but the gospel of peace, the good news that peace can overthrow everything. This means we move into the hardest situations, into the worst battles, into the worst temptations, and we bring peace with us. Will help us move in the midst of all of it. Next, he moves on to the thing that he says is above all of it, the shield of peace. You think about a shield, you can hold it out in front of you, you can literally move it around, protect every part of you. This is the shield of faith. What he says is this shield of faith will protect you from the arrows of the evil one, from the fiery arrows of the evil one. Ones that not only want to pierce you, but set you ablaze, to utterly destroy you. The evil one who wants to tempt you, lead you astray, pierce your heart with so many different feelings, desires that are not in line with God. But that faith, even when doubt strikes us, even when something else wants to lead us through, that faith first reminds us of God's faithfulness, but then allows us to act faithfully, to act out in courage. The helmet of salvation is one that I'm spending a lot of time on right now, because my mind will go a lot of places. It wants to think about a whole lot of things that aren't always God. But protecting your thinking by making salvation one of your primary thoughts, thinking about how God has saved you and is saving you and is saving the world, how that might guide our thinking and our perspective and our understanding of this world. And the last one is the sword of the Spirit, the Word of God. I already find this quite interesting because he parallels the Word of God and the Holy Spirit. And I think this is really important because I love the Bible and I think the Bible is great for all of us, but we have to also recognize that the Holy Spirit is the one that's speaking to us. That it is a living word. It's not simply just words on a page. Because I've seen how those words on a page can really feel like a sword. But not just to attack people to change them and offer them peace, but really feel like violence. And when the Holy Spirit moves in it, when it is God moving through those words, they are all of these things. They are faith. They are truth. They are righteousness. They are salvation. They are hope. And so moving through and allowing the Holy Spirit to move through your words, and He be the one that pierces the hearts of others so that they might be changed. It's interesting that all of this is defense except for the work of the Holy Spirit. So that's how we should move forward, using the very word of God. And Paul goes on to the prayer that comes through the word of God. And that we should wrap ourselves in prayer and courage to speak up, to speak out, to share the mystery of the gospel, which so many people long for. We know our enemy, but we also know our strength. So we need to depend on this strength and trust in all the good things that come from Him. Put on the armor of light. Amen. Our service will continue on page 71 with the Creed. Would you please stand up as we confess our faith together? I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father, and he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. And I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. I beseech you, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. We're going to sing together our offertory hymn, which is hymn 624, which is, O Thou Who Camest From Above, hymn 624.
Oh,
Blessed be thou, Lord God of Israel, forever and ever. All that is in the heaven and in the earth is thine. All things come of thee, and of thine own have we given thee. Amen. Please be seated for prayer. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostles has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all people, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all they that do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also to lead all nations in the way of righteousness, and so to guide and direct their governors and rulers, that thy people may enjoy the blessings of freedom and peace. We pray especially over the election that just happened yesterday, and for the coming election or new leaders that are likely to come into England. And grant unto thy servant Elizabeth, our queen, and to all that are put in authority under her, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the maintenance of thy... And grant unto thy servant Charles, our king, and to all that are put in authority under him, that they may truly and impartially administer justice the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops, priests, and deacons, and especially to thy servants, Andrew, Linda, Anne, Sydney, Priscilla, Kevin, Merv, Gail, and myself, that we may both by our life and doctrine set forth thy true and living word and rightly and duly administer thy sacraments. Prosper, we pray thee, all those who proclaim the gospel of thy kingdom among the nations, and to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present. Jean, Jeff, Richard, Cliff, Bertha, and Eddie. That with meek heart and due reverence, we may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of our life. In our cycle of prayer, we pray for Elaine Ward, Stuart Watt and Sandra Watt and their children, Hillary and Philip, and for Philip's coming wedding, for Ian Witchick, for Verna Wilkinson, Marjorie Williams, for Deborah Williams, their sons Colin and Mitchell, and Alex Wilson. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all them who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. I invite you to name any names aloud or silent that are on your own hearts. We pray for those who have asked for our prayers. For Dorothy, Gail, Anne, Enid, Francis, B, Hubert and Theo, Sudaram, Margaret, Barbara, Tatiana. We remember before the Dunbar family, they mourn. We also lift up in our prayers all those that are preparing for marriage, especially all those that are part of the marriage course. Please, Lord, use this class that it might build for them a foundation for the rest of their lives together, for mutual love and for the sharing of your love. We remember before thee, O Lord, all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear. And we bless thy holy name for all who in life and death have glorified thee, beseeching thee to give us grace that rejoicing in their fellowship we may follow their good examples and with them be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Ye that do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbors, and intend to lead the new life following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confessions to Almighty God, meekly in any position of prayer. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all people, we acknowledge and confess our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father. For thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, for the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Jesus Christ saith unto all that truly turn to him. Come unto me, all that labor and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son to the end that all that believed in him should not perish, but have eternal life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying and worthy of all to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If anyone sins, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. He is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should all, at all times and in all places, give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty, everlasting God, creator and preserver of all things. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, according to the whose most true promise, the Holy Spirit came down, as at this time from heaven, alighting upon the disciples to teach them and to lead them into all truth, giving them both the gifts of tongue and also boldness with fervent zeal, constantly to preach the gospel unto all nations, whereby we have been brought out of darkness and error into the clear light and true knowledge of thee and of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessing and glory and thanksgiving be unto thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to take our nature upon him, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made thereby his one oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and in institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memorial of that his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, thank you, Lord, he broke it. And gave it to his disciples, saying, take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of this. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Whenever you drink this, do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, we thy humble servants with all thy holy church, remembering the precious death of thy beloved Son, his mighty resurrection, and his glorious ascension, and looking for his coming again in glory, do make before thee in the sacrament of the holy bread of eternal life and the cup of everlasting salvation, the memorial which he hath commanded. And we entirely desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of his sins, of our sins, and all other benefits of his passion. And we pray that by the power of thy Holy Spirit, all we who are partakers of this holy communion may be fulfilled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom and with whom in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy bounty. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sin of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sin of the world, grant us thy peace. for you. Eddie, the blood of Christ shed for you. I can invite all the rest to come in a circle. I'll come to you, Jean. Jeff, the body of Christ broken for you. Bertha, the body of Christ broken for you. Richard, the body of Christ broken for you. Cliff, the body of Christ broken for you. Jean, the body of Christ broken for you. Blood of Christ shed for you. Bertha, the blood of Christ shed for you. Richard, the blood of Christ shed for you. Let's continue in our prayer with the prayer that Jesus Christ himself taught us. So let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee that thou dost graciously feed us in these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, assuring us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are living members of his mystical body, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom. Together. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee. And although we are unworthy, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen. Before we jump into our closing hymn, just a few quick announcements. Tonight is Parish Council. If you've never been a part of it, it's a little bit of a meeting, but it's more about communicating what is happening in the church. So it's a chance for a lot of people to just let you know what's happening in their ministries. And then for us as a community, this one specifically, is we're gonna be discussing the events and hopeful trajectory of some kind of this church. And so sort of both looking forward for what's happening this year, but then also what we wanna do as a community. And so it's really about looking forward and with hope and with excitement. And so if you want to, you're more than welcome to join us. It's all online, so the link will go out if it hasn't already gone out shortly. There's more happening and now I'm just blanking out on all of it. But one thing I would really encourage you to think about joining is the Chosen Conversation. So it will be a conversation on a web series called The Chosen. We're gonna watch it together. It's a little under an hour, and we're gonna look at some of these really important stories. It's basically a modern retelling of the Jesus story, except putting more of a focus on the disciples. Where would the disciples be coming from that would bring them to this place? What might they be struggling with? And so there's a lot for us to connect with and see how the gospel speaks to our own lives. So I'd encourage you to join that. There's a discussion happening on November 8th, and then every week following for the next 4 weeks, there is a Bible study. So I hope you can join us for that. There's more happening, but look out on the calendar and that sort of thing for all of that. Now let's stand and sing together our closing hymn, 631, which is hymn.
The kingdom of God is justice and joy.
Kingdom of God is justice and joy. So it is.
Justice and joy.
in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.